Okay, sir. Yeah, yesterday we started with a field service process, and we have completed the operation planning of cost and planning of labor cost and material cost. Okay, now we will do the actuals. So IW41 is a transaction where we actually confirm the operations. This is a transaction. Okay, so let me go to create one more order. Yeah, so S1 is my notification. I'm going to create a S1. I'll put confirmations.
Sir, S2 select yes, no, correct? Right? Notification.
Ah, yeah. Okay. Yes, sir. Since we are doing a field service, so S2 will work. I'll go to service order SM02, planning plan 1000, and main work center PC rep 1000. Okay, so 2 hours for this confirmation. And I'll go to components. I'll add MI-116, one quantity, and it's a stock material. So we'll see the non-stock material later. I'll come back. Okay, so order is saved and notification is saved. So I'll go to the order, service order. So this is my service order. I'm going to release. So before release, I'll just see the planned cost. So we have a planned cost of labor for 252 and 925. So this value is coming from KP26, and this is coming from material master accounting tab. So this we have completed yesterday. Okay. So now I will release this order. So once I release, this is eligible for actual postings. I'll save this. Now I'll go to W41. This is my transaction to go and post the cost. When is the work started? This is the date. Okay, so I'm planning for 1 hour. So initially I planned for 2 hours, but actual cost, actual duration, what the technician has spent is, so assume that 4 hours. Okay. It is which I check parameters.
Date, past date, students. Like, leather eval date, I know.
Yeah, I put 5th.
Work finished at home.
Now I will go to IW32 to see that what is the cost posted. Okay, now we'll go to the operations. So this is 2 hours is my planned work value. I'll go to the cost. Actual cost has not come. Okay, confirmation number range is missing. So this is a configuration. Put SPR. Yeah, so this is a configuration which creates one confirmation in the backend. So that we'll go and see it here. The service orders, we have it in plant maintenance and customer service. Service processing, we'll go to the service orders. Generator type of component. So notification, we have a number ranges for confirmation. Proposed defined services, costing data, change management. This is not there. General data is component movement type for material account assignment, document purchasing, current data default, user status for orders, scheduling, print control, message control, object information. No, it's not available here. Maintain service processing warranty lines, complete confirmations. Variance execution time for processing, scheduling background job.
ఒకసారి ఎఫ్ ఫోర్ కొట్టి సెర్చ్ చేయండి సార్ లేకపోతే
నెంబర్ రేంజ్ మిస్సింగ్ కన్ఫర్మేషన్ కి
ఒకసారి అది పిన్ చేయరా ఎర్రర్ మెసేజ్
ఎగ్జిస్ట్ ఫర్ ఆర్ పిఎల్జి అకౌంటింగ్ డాక్యుమెంట్ ఇది కానీ అది ఎక్కడి నుంచి వచ్చిందో చూడాలి. రెస్పాన్సిబిలిటీ స్పెసిఫై నెంబర్ 751. ఓకే, ఎఫ్పిఎన్ అకౌంటింగ్ డాక్యుమెంట్
ఎర్రర్ మెసేజ్ అనిపి కదా పైన, ఇది
751. 751 ఇక్కడ ఉంది ఎర్రర్ మెసేజ్. We can go to we'll go to slash o snro rf underscore BELG. We'll see what is this one. Number ranges for accounting document. Okay, accounting document number ranges slash obyc. ఏది ఎఫ్పి ఎన్ వన్ ట్రాన్సాక్షన్ ఎఫ్పి ఎన్ వన్ కంపెనీ కోడ్ ఇస్ 1000. సో విల్ టేక్ 2021. ఐ థింక్ నెంబర్ రేంజ్ ఇస్ నాట్ ద సేమ్.
In the save,
I'll go to IW 32. Number of confirmation saved is 1 year. Operation, I'll go to the actuals. Yeah, now it is saved. Okay, so you can see actual work for 4 hours. Now we'll see the actual cost. Still actuals are not posted. Go to log, past iteration. Actual hours is posted, cost is not coming. So this is actual cost should come here, right? Internal labor. So this is a planned and actual cost report. Okay, so we have planned, this is planned cost, actual cost is not posted. This is
from IW32 report.
This is from IW32. It's called as normally OKKB. This report will be generated from CO, it's integrated to CS. Okay, you see here the product consumed is 925 and activity actual report is 252 for 2 hours. This is planned one. The actual should come here. This we'll see. Total maintenance overhead is 25. Okay, so something is missing again. I'll just save this order. I will do 1 to 1. To go and add 1 more hour
fresh the create the answer lekapothe fresh order.
I'm adding 1 more operation, so this will enable for
kottadi kottadi create cheyandi antunna oka order IW 51
sam service. This is for 4 hours, or I'll put as 5 hours. Now it is saved. IW32. Okay, total 5 hours is posted, and we'll go to the cost. Yeah, so it has come now. Okay, internal level total hours is 378 is planned, and the actuals is 738. If you go to the operation for operation actual data, you'll see what is the total value. Okay, so this is for 5 hours is posted. Previous one, it's a number range issue, which is not coming. I'll create a fresh one.
Okay, okay.
సంతోష్ సార్, ఇదే ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఈ కేసులోనే ఒకవేళ కొటేషన్ తీసుకున్నాం అనుకోండి, మీరు కొటేషన్ వచ్చి నాకు 4 అవర్స్కి ఇచ్చారు, మరి బిల్డింగ్ వచ్చేసరికి కస్టమర్ యాక్సెప్ట్ చేసాడు, మళ్ళీ బిల్డింగ్ వచ్చేసరికి నాకు 5 అవర్స్ అయింది, దాన్ని ఎలా సార్ అప్పుడు?
Normally in general scenarios we will give whatever the confirmed cost. Only few customers will not accept. For them we have to give what is accepted as per the quotation. So in this case we have not done any quotation. Okay, so yeah, if there is a quotation and it is accepted, then we have to bill based on the quotation only. Okay,
even if it is consumed more hours also.
Some customer they won't accept. They will say whatever I accepted, you have to bill based on the quotation only. Mm-hmm. So that scenario will be only rare. Mostly we will take it as a normally this kind of scenarios will be with high value customers.
Yeah, yeah.
In regular, we will take it as whatever the billing is there. So we will give quotation only on demand. It's not a normal process. Quotation is only customer is requesting for a quotation, then only we'll generate, or else it will be normal billing only. Okay, so I'm now releasing this. Okay, so I'll save this. Now I'll go to IW41. Yeah, so this is my value which I'm booking. I planned for 2 hours. I'm booking for 6 hours. Okay, I'll say this is a final confirmation. I'll save it. Okay. Now go to the component. Yeah, 6 hours confirmed. And you go to the cost tab, you'll see total 252 is your planned cost and 759 is your actual.
Sir, ippudu manu rent transaction vartunu IW31 for creation okadanno, malli IW41 vachesi deeniki
kuda. IW41 is only for confirmation posting. Actually, when we are planning during that time, we are not we are not posting any value. It's only planned value which we entered there, but confirmation somebody has to post. So they will post using a different transaction, IW41. That in case if your back office is posting or if a technician is posting, they will use IW41 transaction in SAP. Okay, that value will be called as actual, because while you do the actual posting, there will be some FI and CO transactions also. In case if it's a labor posting, it will be CO transaction. In case if you are doing it for material, it will be a FI posting. So that's the reason we are using a different transaction. But in case of a planned value, right, it will not hit any accounting document. It only just a planned value it will show.
Okay.
So now if I go to the report, okay, so actual 752, if I double click this value, costing row. So if you double click in the back end, it will show you what is the value it posted. So 756 your value which is posted. So this is the number range which is asking 01. So you can see this number range. Banjo FB03. Yeah, so this is my confirmation, actual confirmation which I posted. This is the number. You see, there will be some number. Display document. And this is a document number and cost element. This is going to partners. Overhead. Okay, this is posting to overhead class. Okay, this is something which is created in the backend. Either it can be a FI or CO transaction. Normally, since we are only using the secondary cost, it should be CO transaction. So CO level, they can understand what is this value. But actually, in technical terms, this is the value which posted to our service order. Okay, this is a confirmation, actual confirmation, 756 hours. In detail, if you want, just we need to see the CO transaction, but it's not our responsibility. I will exit this list. Okay, so this is my plan cost, 252 for 2 hours, and this is my total cost for 6 hours. So there is a difference. Now, when I do a billing, it will post according to 756. Now, what I will do, we go to DP90, this is a transaction. DP80, what we saw yesterday, is for quotation. That's only for plan cost. Now DP90 is for actuals. What is confirmed, that value will come here. Okay. Thousand 1000. Go to DP90. Come like yesterday, we have not assigned this. Sales and distribution. Sales document header. We need to assign this document to our sales area.
Yes, the document type of thing
yesterday. The document choose for an ODP one. IRC, IRE. So this is document IRC.
IRC.
Okay, so now it's done. I will go to class and DP90. Using this order, I will process the billing. So we have a repair hour, and 756 is the total value of repair hour for how many hours? For 6 hours. You can click on this and go to the quantity. It will show you the quantity, 6 hours. Okay. So if you double click this value, repair hour, you will see what is the cost element and what is the cost center, what is the activity type. Based on this combination, system will try to find out one dynamic item. Okay, I'll just save the billing request. Okay, so this is the repair hour. So how it's coming? It's coming from the ODP1 transaction. If I go to ODP1 here, click on the billing request, material determination. So this is a repair hour. If you click on this, it will show you the criteria. So this is the activity type, 1410. Okay. And this is my cost center 14100. You can see both are available here. 1410 4100. That's the reason this material is determined from the ODB1 transaction. For 6 hours, the value. Go to the conditions. So the value which is coming is 756. It's a cost, total cost which incurred for us for doing the service. But we are putting some additional value. So say for example 200. This is the price which we gave to the customer. So total 1200 is a billing amount to the customer. The cost incurred is 756. There is a markup 1200, and we are billing to the customer. So when I create, when I save this document, it will create a debit memory request. Now I can go to IW32 789. Okay, go to the costing tab. So here, immediately once you create a debit memory request, there is a status called PTBL. PTBL is nothing but it's a planned revenue has come. You can go and see the revenue. You will be able to see the revenue. It's only actuals. We'll go to the report. Okay, so there will be some revenue, domestic revenue. It's a 1200. This is nothing but your price in the debit memory request. So this is your planned value, this is your actual cost, and this is your planned revenue. There is no actual revenue. Actual revenue will come only in case when you are doing the billing. Okay, so you can find out the what is my planned value. Total planned revenue. We need total planned revenue. I'm just saying this. This is a quantity variance. Revenue target cost version.
Revenue surplus so affecting net value.
This is only showing in the plan while cost only. I'll save this one. Yeah, so I'll go inside this. I will go to document flow. So only the status you need to understand. So after you do a billing or after you do a debit memory request, there will be one more status called PTBL. Once you complete the confirmation, it will show CNF. Okay, so now I will go to the document flow. Here in the document flow, debit memo is created. So this is nothing but your planned revenue has come. Okay, now I'll do billing for this BF01. Any billing block? There is a block. So now I'll go to BF02. It's a billing block, debit memo block. I will remove this one. Billing block. I'll do billing directly. Okay, now I'm just saving this document. Once you save it, now I go to IW32.
So in the debit memo request create in the
that's only debit memo request. This is a billing, actual billing.
Debit memo. Okay.
Debit memo. So you come here and see revenue is supposed to be posted. Okay, this is still open, but revenue should come. And go to here. You see, actual should come here. This is a planned revenue, domestic revenue. This actual revenue is not posted. Accounting document is not there. IW30E02. Accounting document is not released open. What is the reason? Oh, again, VPN on 14 is missing. Okay. So, FI settings are not present. Okay. I'll go to UPN1. 1000. This is for 14. So 14 is not assigned in 2021. So that is the reason. This is company code. This is a 14 where the 14 number range are created. So 14 2000 we'll take from here. I'm just releasing this order. Yeah, account document is posted. Now I will go and see the document flow. So we have a service order, we have debit memo request, accounting document is also there. Go to IW32.
సార్ దీంట్లో నోటిఫికేషన్ అయింది ఏం కనపడదా డాక్యుమెంట్ ఫ్లోలో
ఇక్కడ సర్వీస్ ఆర్డర్ నుంచి వెళ్తే కనపడతా
సర్వీస్ ఆర్డర్ నుంచి వెళ్తే డెబిట్ మెమో నుంచి వెళ్తే కనపడదు
డెబిట్ మెమో మనం రిక్వెస్ట్ క్రియేట్ చేసింది విత్ రిఫరెన్స్ టు సర్వీస్ ఆర్డర్ కదా
సర్వీస్ ఆర్డర్ అవును అవును ఓకే
So cost. Actual cost revenue has gone. Okay, so this is your revenue. You understand, no? This is your total actual revenue. Actually, this should be a cost and revenue, plan cost, plan revenue. Okay, this is a report where it shows what is your total revenue. So this is hitting to different GL account, cost element.
సార్ ఒకసారి ఇంకో సినారియో క్రియేట్ చేయరా ఎందుకంటే అంటే స్టాఫ్ ఫ్లోలో ఫ్లో ఉంటుంది అనేసి అంతే అంటే మధ్యలో ఒక నిమిషం అంటే ఇందాక మనం మధ్యలో వచ్చేసి నంబర్ రేంజెస్ అవి చేసుకుంటూ వెళ్తాం కదా ఇది ఒక ఫ్లో క్రియేట్ చేసేయండి ఫస్ట్ నుంచి ఫస్ట్ ఒకటి నోటిఫికేషన్ క్రియేట్ చేస్తే నోటిఫికేషన్ ఆ తర్వాత నుంచి సర్వీస్ ఆర్డర్ ఆ తర్వాత నుంచి ఏముందో మొత్తం ఇంకా అలాగ స్టెప్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ చేసుకుంటూ వెళ్తే మనకు కొంచెం ఫ్లో ఉంటుంది అనేసి రిఫర్ చేసడానికి
One notification for field service I'm creating, and this is my sold to, which has given a complaint for us, and this is the equipment which he mentioned as a problem. I'll click on the service order S702. Okay, so this is my work center, and this is my value. This is my planning plan. This is my I'm planning for operations. So I'll plan for 1 hour of operation. So technical field service and antivirus. I will plan for 2. Okay, so antivirus is for 2 hours. So I'm planning these 2 operations, and I will just try to release this order. You can see the cost now. So total cost is 3. You can go to the cost.
స్క్రీన్ షేరింగ్ కొంచెం స్లోగా ఉంది సార్ ఎందుకో
నౌ ఐ యామ్ ఇన్ ద సర్వీస్ ఆర్డర్ ఓన్లీ
కరెక్ట్ సర్వీస్ ఆర్డరే మీరు మన వర్డ్కను స్క్రీన్కి కొంచెం ఒక 5 సెకండ్స్ డిఫరెన్స్ ఉంది 5 సెకండ్స్
ఓకే ఓకే ఐ జస్ట్ లెట్ మీ నో అండ్ కరెంట్లీ ఐ యామ్ ఇన్ టు ద క్వాంటిటీ ట్యాబ్ ఓకే ఇంటర్నల్ లెవర్స్ ఐ జస్ట్ ప్లాన్ ఫర్ 3 అవర్స్ బికాజ్ ఇన్ ద ఆపరేషన్స్ ఐ ప్లాన్ ఫర్ 2 ఆపరేషన్స్ వన్ ఇస్ ఫర్ field service as a text 1 hour and antivirus run is for 2 hours. So in the cost tab you will see the total quantity as 3 and the total cost for planned cost is 378. Okay, so now I am releasing the service order. So once I release the service order, I am now I can system will allow me to post the confirmations. So I will save this order.
After save also we can able to release it, no?
You can release anytime, you can release. So once I go into the service order now, you see the status is REL and material not committed, pre-costed and a CTC settlement. You can see here. This is released, no material components, pre-costed, settlement rule created. So what I will do now, I'll go to slash and IW41. I will plan for confirmations. So there are 2 operations. One is for 1 hour and another one is 2 hours. Planned work.
Sir, in real time also confirmation will do with the, who will do this one?
Back office team. Your
consultant will not be involved, right? Here in this transaction.
So real time production, it is not our view. Production, it will be used man end user transaction.
End user, they will do it. IW41. No. Like confirmation, what is the purpose? After service order creation, for example, I am the technician, okay, and for me already it is taking the 4 hours or 3 hours and all. I came for the some laptop service or AC service and all. I have done the my actuals. It is already in the service order. They mentioned as in the notification, they mentioned as the 3 hours, but now actually work is it is taking the 4 to 5 hours. Already that is in the service order is created for the how many hours? For 3 hours, correct? Based on the notification.
Correct.
Now you are doing the order confirmation. Order confirmation, I have done the 5 hours, but in the notification, whatever it may be, the service order, they mention you mentioned as the 3 hours, correct?
Correct.
But how backend team will know whether service engineer is over for the 5 hours?
service engineer has to tell you
what confirmation they will take it, and what based on that they will mention as the confirmation. I mean, final confirmation.
No, no. See, you are, as a technician, I am going to a customer place. I spend 4 hours, and I will inform to the back office for this order, which I came to the customer place. I have planned hours is 4 hours, but after doing a checkup, I am posting 5 hours. He will confirm back to him. So this
correct,
is the
any documentation or through oral?
No,
or
through oral only. You will send a mail or you will call him and he will say as a ECC system. But S4HANA, this is integrated to FSM. Where on the mobile, he will put 5 hours. It will post a confirmation here in SAP.
Okay.
So nobody is doing in the S4HANA system. So
in ECC,
ECC also, we have FSM integration, but otherwise, it will be the person technician will call the back office and explain.
Okay. There is no any other transaction and other
documentation. No. Either it will be manually or through FSM. Only these two ways we have. Or some other, they say CATS tool. CATS tool will also integrate here. But here, CATS is your normally CAT2, CAT9, CATS. So there are some transactions where they will actually post the total number of hours in that. So for which service order, which activity he has performed, those details he has to take, and it will come and post here. Assume CATS will not be normally used by in across the platform. You have two options. One is manual, where technician will call to the help desk and he mentioned for this service order, I worked for 5 hours.
Hmm.
Okay, technician confirmation will be taken by back office team and he will post here.
For example, నాకు ఓన్లీ 3 గంటలు పడింది అనుకోండి, నేను సర్వీస్ నోటిఫికేషన్ ఐ హావ్ అండ్ దే మెన్షన్ యాజ్ 3 అవర్స్ ఎస్టిమేషన్ యాజ్ వెల్ యాజ్ ది సర్వీస్ ఆర్డర్ ఆల్సో దే మెన్షన్ యాజ్ 3 అవర్స్ ఫర్ మీ యాక్చువల్ ఆల్సో ఇట్ ఈస్ వర్కింగ్ యాజ్ 3 మినిట్స్ ఆల్మోస్ట్ ఫ్లెక్సిబిలిటీ 3 అవర్స్ ఓన్లీ. నౌ ఆన్ ద టైమ్ ఆల్సో వీ నీడ్ టు బి మెయింటైన్ ఫర్ దిస్ కన్ఫర్మేషన్ ఆర్డర్.
యా 3 అవర్స్ యు నోట్ బట్ బేసికల్లీ ద కన్ఫర్మేషన్ ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ ఇట్ విల్ పోస్ట్ ద యాక్చువల్ వాల్యూస్ టు యువర్ CO అండ్ FI ట్రాన్సాక్షన్స్. ప్లాన్డ్ వాల్యూ విల్ నాట్ పోస్ట్ ఎనీథింగ్.
Okay, based on the service order and notification, it won't be post. Only based on the order confirmation, it will post.
It will post, yes.
Okay.
So one of the activity, I posted for 4 hours. Now I will go to IW32. So in the IW32, I have two operations. One is posted actuals. Okay, 4 hours is posted. So second one, since I have not done anything, it will show as a partial confirmation. Okay, so now again I will go to IW41. Okay, so you see this actuals are posted. So that's why you cannot again go back to the first one. Second one is pending. I will go to the second one. For 2 hours, I will say, say for example, I planned for 2 hours, but I am now doing only for 1.5. Okay.
సార్ ఈవెన్ దో నేను 4 గంటలు పని చేసి 2 గంటలకి బిల్ చేయొచ్చా యాక్చువల్ వర్క్ 2 అవర్స్ అనేసి?
దట్ విల్ బి లాస్ ఫర్ యు.
ఏదైనా కానీ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ నాకు యూజర్ కి మిస్ అండర్స్టాండింగ్ ఉందనుకోండి.
యా సిస్టమ్ విల్ అలో బట్ ఇట్ విల్ బి లాస్ వెన్ యు ఆర్ క్యాలిక్యులేటింగ్ యువర్ కాస్ట్ విల్ బి మోర్ దాన్ ద యువర్ యాక్చువల్స్. సో వాట్ ఎవర్ యు ఆర్ టేకింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ ద కస్టమర్, that cost will be less than what you planned. So for example, I am doing a service now, Maruti showroom, you went for automobile for your car service. So car service is actually costing some 1,000 rupees, but you are billing to the customer, so the Maruti showroom has billed you only 800. So that will be lost to Maruti, right? Same way here also, if you are posting less cost than what you actually worked, so that will be your customer will not pay you the amount what you actually spent, and in the accounting books it will show you the cost incurred for doing the service is more than what is the billing.
No, if I want to give you some discount
that you can do it during the billing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you see the total value is 378 and 693 is my actual cost.
So
okay, if I go to the quantity,
always the actual should be equal to planned or more than the planned.
Yeah, always it will be more than planned. Okay, so this is what we plan. Now go to the revenue reporting. So here see 398
is. Sir, small question. No, par indaka manam maatladukunnattu meeru kuda chepparu kada. Okokkari some customers manam estimation 4 hours ki icham anukondi. Due to criticality something and all, it is went to the up to 6 to 7 hours. Okay, assume that.
Mm-hmm.
But now already he has accepted the that our agreement, it should be work, we have to finish within the 4 hours something and all. But on that time also it will be company will be lost. So how can we the wages to that one?
No, he is a regular customer, right? So once in a while your regular customer has a based on the goodwill, you will give a discount. So normally in the real time scenario, that will be only one or two cases.
Yes. I mean, no. My question is okay. Correct. We'll give the discount in billing, but is it not possible in the service order level and notification level?
No. When you are dealing with the customer, always it comes from the sales order route. From service order, it only captures the cost and revenue. But billing and all, we have to see the discounts or whatever the tax, everything, it should come from the billing only, SG route.
Correct. But in the report level, when they are going to refer service order with reference to the invoice, debit memory request with reference to notification and service order only they will create, right? Difference will be there, right? In the
Okay, I'll show you. So currently I planned is 693. Now we have not done any revenue. We have not created any billing. We'll do a billing. We'll see what is your question.
Okay.
You tell me the what is the amount you want, or we will do it. Now I'll just save this one. I'm creating a debit memory request using a TP90. 90 is my value. Okay, location, I'll put 1000. And I'll put 0. Okay, company code is copied, I will save this. Now I'll do TP90 for this order. I'll go inside this service order. So now this is my billing request. I'm creating a billing request. Now you tell me the value. What is the value you want? So it's creating a debit memory request. Okay. So this is my, I planned for 5.5 hours. Okay. Now this is my cost. 693 is my cost. What is the amount you want to put? You want to put...
Make it 5.5 only.
No, 5.5 is the quantity, and what is the total value you want to put? So maybe I will give as a 200. Okay.
200 means it is the increase, no?
200, I will give a discount. What is the discount you want? So maybe K004, I will give a discount of...
Give 100 rupees.
100. Okay, this is not there. We'll see how any discount is there. Discount condition. From net discount from gross. Okay, RA00, there is a discount. I'll go to this discount. You want 100 rupees, huh? So total value is 1100 and RA discount is 100 rupees. Oh, it is giving complete discount 1000, which is adding discount
50%.
100% discount from net percentage of discount, it's adding the value. Okay, so we need to put as a minus.
Minus of the change.
So 275 is a discount value. It will remove 275 from 1100. 825 is your total value. You want to add one more discount?
No.
Okay, so this is your taxes 123. Total value which is coming is 948. This is your line item price and before tax, and the total value is 948. Any other you want?
No, no. Okay. Leave it.
Any other discount? If you want, I can add one more discount. So there is a goodwill price. KMB1.
The new price will be created, no?
It will be discount. So this will be total 829. What I'm giving is I'm just giving for say 700. We'll see how it calculates. This is adding 700%. So 742 is a goodwill price, 110. I'm calculating for 110. I planned for 100. I planned for 200. Okay. So, but now I'm calculating on 110 rupees. So this is the total value. 742 is your total amount which you are charging the customer. You understand now? So when you go and see the revenue, so the revenue will be, total revenue will be your 853. Okay, I'll save this one. IW32 90. Go to the operations or cost, partially billed. You go to the categories. So here revenue will be total revenue 990. This is not including the goodwill. 990. We'll see how where from where it is coming. Sales revenue 990, total plan 990, debit 120 component 25 is your cost group. Okay, we'll create a billing document. BF01 billing block is there. Okay, BA02.
సార్ ఇక్కడ డాక్యుమెంట్ ఫ్లోలో కాకుండా ఎక్కడ ఒకటి అప్డేట్ కాదా డాక్యుమెంట్ లెవెల్లో ఫ్లోలో కాకుండా సేల్స్ అదే ఆర్డర్ నంబర్
ఇది మీ డెబిట్ మా రిక్వెస్ట్
అవుదా సార్
అలా అవుదు
ఓకే ఓకే
ఇది కాంట్రాక్ట్ అవుతుంది ఇది అవుదు ఓకే సో VA0 VF01 So total value 742. 990 is what value showing revenue is. Okay, so I'll just save this one. We'll see from where it is coming.
Then go on to debit memo lo kuda price changes coach kada.
Changes coach. Billing is created. I'll go to the cost. $998. So 1,000 is the value. This is a customer, but 990 is from where it's coming. 100 is a discount. Okay, 1,000 plus 100. Total value 1,000, what we cost, we will put a price for the customer and we gave a discount of 110. So total change is 990. Okay, so he is my payer and this will hit to your GL account.
Sir, when you have a calendar, document like Ellen Monkey, price into your debit memo like VF02 like.
So what it is showing is a condition. If I go here, this is the total price 110. Okay, for total 5 hours. 5.5 hours. And discount was given as a 110 rupees.
But man value vachesi 853 kada sir.
850 plus tax kuda undu kada.
Adhe adhe mottham kalukunde 853 including tax.
853 so we have one more value.
ఇది నెట్ టు ప్రైస్ కాదు మీకు పోస్ట్ అయింది యాక్చువల్ గా
ఇంక్లూడింగ్ ట్యాక్స్
అందుకని మీకు 990 చూపిస్తుంది యాక్చువల్ గా అది ఏంటంటే అనుక
డిస్కౌంట్ చూసారా 990 డిస్కౌంట్ తో కలిపి ఏం చేసింది అంటే 110 డిస్కౌంట్ 110 గుడ్ విల్ డిస్కౌంట్ ఇచ్చారు
టోటల్ గుడ్ విల్ డిస్కౌంట్ అను ప్లస్ టోటల్ వాల్యూ లోంచి తీసేశారు అంతే
ట్యాక్స్ సెపరేట్ గా పోస్ట్ చేయాలి ఆ ట్యాక్స్ దీనికి జిఎల్ అకౌంట్ ఉండుండు సిట్టింగ్ ఎఫ్ఐ సైడ్
మనకి అకౌంటింగ్ క్లియర్ అయిపోతే మన సైడ్ నుంచి అయిపోయినట్టు క్లియర్ బానే ఉంది మనకి అమౌంట్ తో సంబంధం లేదులే మనకి ట్రాన్సాక్షన్ క్లియర్ ఉండాలి ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ఒక నిమిషం సార్ ఫస్ట్ నేను చెప్తాను ఫ్లో మీరు కరెక్షన్ చేయండి రాంగ్ అయితే ఓకేనా సార్ మీ అందరి టీంకి ఎవరికన్నా సరే ఏమైనా డౌట్స్ ఉన్నా సరే నేను ఏమైనా అడిగేది ఏమన్నా ఇది అనిపిస్తే సరే కొంచెం స్టాప్ చేయండి ఓకేనా ఫస్ట్ మనం సర్వీస్ నోటిఫికేషన్ క్రియేట్ చేస్తాము స్టార్టింగ్ ఇనిషియల్గా విత్ రెఫరెన్స్ టు నోటిఫికేషన్ వీ విల్ క్రియేట్ యాజ్ ఎ సర్వీస్ ఆర్డర్ అండ్ విత్ రెఫరెన్స్ టు సర్వీస్ ఆర్డర్ ఇన్ ద సర్వీస్ ఆర్డర్ లెవెల్ వీ విల్ మెయింటైన్ యాజ్ ది యాక్చువల్ అవర్స్ ఓకే ప్లాన్డ్ అవర్స్ కరెక్టా విత్ ద రెఫరెన్స్ టు ద ప్లాన్డ్ అవర్స్ అండ్ బేస్డ్ ఆన్ ది టెక్నీషియన్ కన్ఫర్మేషన్ దెన్ అగైన్ వీ విల్ పోస్ట్ ది యాక్చువల్ అవర్స్ త్రూ IW41 After postings and all, we will create the, once again, we will check in the service order. With reference to service order, we will create the debit memo request.
Correct.
After debit memo request, debit memo request, we will create the debit memo. This is the final invoice.
Yeah, correct.
Final invoice to the customer, correct? ఓకే ఇక్కడ దీంట్లోనే మనం అవుట్పుట్ ఏమైనా పెట్టుకోవాలన్నా సార్ దీంట్లో పెట్టుకోవచ్చు ఎన్ని రకాలుగా పెట్టుకోవచ్చు సార్ ఐ మీన్ నోటిఫికేషన్ లెవెల్లో కూడా అవుట్పుట్ పెట్టుకోవచ్చా
నోటిఫికేషన్ లెవెల్ అంటే అవుట్పుట్ అంటే మీరు కస్టమర్ ఇచ్చే
అవుట్పుట్ టైప్ కరెక్ట్
షాప్ పేపర్ యా దట్ ఆల్సో యు కెన్ డు ఇట్
నోటిఫికేషన్ లెవెల్ కూడా
యా వి కెన్ అప్లై ఇట్ ఫర్ ఎట్ నోటిఫికేషన్ లెవెల్ వి కెన్ డు ఇట్ ఎట్ ఫర్ సర్వీస్ ఆర్డర్ లెవెల్
డెబిట్ మెమో లెవెల్ డెబిట్ మెమో రిక్వెస్ట్ లెవెల్ ఈ నాలుగు లెవెల్లో చేసుకోవచ్చు అయితే ఓకే రాజేష్ రవి కిరణ్ అండ్ వెంకట్ ఎనీ డౌట్స్ ప్లీజ్ ఆస్క్
క్లియర్ అంటే పర్లేదు
ఓకే సో హియర్ వి హావ్ యాక్చువల్ కాస్ట్ సో నౌ వన్స్ వి కంప్లీట్ బిల్లింగ్ టు ద కస్టమర్ 799 billing to the customer we will set this to TECO which means so this order is technically completed we don't need anything unless there is some FI postings those are allowed other than those nothing will be allowed okay so we are technically completing the order so finally once we receive the bill we will do our technical completion so that is nothing but order is technically completed we don't have anything pending okay you see TECO TECO You understand? So we cannot post anything and there will be some FA postings allowed that will be done outside of your service transactions. They will do you FB01, FB02, some other transaction they will use and they will post it.
Sir, once the CLSD completed, we cannot open it back.
Huh? We can open it back. See, for example, if you want to make any change here, you can just say cancel technically complete. It will go to release again. Settlement is the value currently, what is the value available here, this is showing as a received value. You see, you have received some amount, domestic sales 990, total value is your cost is 693, okay, but your revenue is 990, so there is some 247 rupees is available. So total variance is 277. 4950 is the amount which is available. So this available amount we need to transfer. So that means nothing but what is my planned cost and what is the actual cost I am transferring to the CO team, CO books. How do I transfer is, you do a settlement. So for this revenue bearing, it is going to the profit COPA. So now for settling, I will do KO ATA transaction. Normally this will be year and month and closing. Your CO team will do. I'll just show you how it will hit. Okay, what is the settlement period is 11. Okay, fiscal year is
2021.
Okay, I'll remove this, execute. Okay, settlement is done. Now I'll come down. Settlement is executed. I will execute the settlement report. It will show you the order. So this is my sender and this is a receiver. So what is the sender? 504974790. This is my sender, which is nothing but your service order. And this is a receiver. And what is the total amount is 4950. Okay, you can just click here. Accounting documents, you have a probability analysis controlling documents. Okay, it will give you the total accounting document. So your value 990 is your revenue, okay, and 247 is your variance and 693 is your cost. So this is a from this amount to this amount it is going, means this is my sender and this is my receiver. Again my cost also is going, again my planned cost is going, this is a variance amount and this cost amount. So all these values will go to the COPA. You understand, right? So this is the amount which settled. So there is no pending amount which is not settled. I will go to profitability analysis. So profitability analysis, which value is coming, from which it is coming, customer, this is my sales organization, and industry, manufacturing industry. So all these values we have. This will take from different transactions. Okay. So origin of data, this is my service order, and this is my cost element, which is carrier. And who has created, when it was created, all these things it will show you. Okay, so this is created on 7 at 1 o'clock. Clear? So profit center document, it will only show you the profit. Okay, so there is no pending amount. So now once I go back here to the service order, IW31, the value will show as a 0. Okay, so now the value is showing as a 0, so which means completely the cost is transferred. So there is no settling amount, balance amount is not there. Now I can do a closure. I'll change this to complete and business closure. Okay, if I go inside, it will show as a closed. If you want to do it again something, I can come back and say complete and remove. Cancel business closure, it will go to take one. Clear? It's clear,
yes,
right?
Yes, 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 yes.
Yeah. So with this, our part will be completely completed. Okay. So this is the report IW73. So how many service orders you have created, you can just find out. That's on 02 and execute. So you have these many service orders with SM02. With SM01, how many are there? Like this, you can just go and see the report. And any other values you want to see, cost value, revenue value, anything, you can come and see it here. This is the total planned value, total actuals, planned revenue, actual revenue, total planned, any other details you want, you can just come and see it here. Okay, so this is your complete picture. You understand, right?
Santosh, after creating of this billing document, can we make any modifications in the service notification or service order?
Unless it is TICO, we can make some changes. Not all changes are allowed. Again, you need to go and see the status, system status, what are allowed. So there is a transaction called BS23. Once you do a TICO, what are all allowed will be shown here. So we want what we can do, right? TICO, yeah. So I click on here. So what are allowed is, you can accept a flag, you can set acceptance flag, change documents are allowed, block assembly order is allowed, unblock is allowed, complete is allowed, okay? Locking is allowed. Technically complete revoke is allowed. We have a revoke of taking completion. What is not allowed is, you cannot change the milestones, you cannot change your relationships, you cannot change your release of service orders. So you cannot, for again, technically complete, you cannot make it. Receipt, you cannot make it. So like this, there will be some which are not allowed, some are allowed.
Sir, until the standard, we cannot make it as a warning message like
no. This is standard, it will not allow you to change. It
we
will
cause change it even though, correct, no?
Correct.
Okay. In the transaction, BS23. Adi not only the tech of Gada, any transaction key is akkada untundi anukuntunna, evaithe kavalani.
System status, entire system status, what is allowed, what is not allowed, will show there.
IW 73
is a report which show you your complete transactions, SM03 or SM02. This will give you a complete list of service orders we created.
Santosh, it tables entendi check cheyadaniki service orders or
Service order is SE16. You have AUFK. AUFK will give you a total service order.
Okay.
Okay, just execute, it will show you all the service orders, list of service orders. And if you want anything to be specific to a date, you can choose it from field services, order type, SM02. Okay, so once you execute, it will give you the list of service orders created.
Okay,
so this is a service order table. AUFK, AFK will be there. This is specific to the operations. Okay, and other one is AFPO. This is also specific to line item level. So here, this notification service orders mainly not only for CS, right? So same category we use, same table we use for project systems, we use for plant maintenance, and also we use for linear asset management. So based on the order type, you can differentiate. Okay, EFPO, EFPO, EUFK, and EFEC. If any integration with your EFEC sales order, you will find out here. So just you have a sales order here, standard order, plant. We'll just execute. We'll see what will come. Yeah, this will give you the relation between operations and service orders, AFEC. And we also have one more link to AF star. Yeah, confirmation, you can see it from a FRV, order confirmation, FRU. These two are confirmations. So there is one more table with reference to sales order, that is ABFV1. FU, FVC is operations within the order, and so sales order level we can see that is F. That list I will share that list with you. So there is a complete list where you can find out the list of tables. Okay, and QML, this is for service order, your notification, QML. You can find out the total number of notifications created. With reference to the date, we can find out. Maybe I'll go here and filter it based on the document type created by. Okay, so whatever we created, S2 we have created. I'll just execute. Yeah, so these menu we have created. Okay. So this is the process of field service. We can see the in-house. So we have seen the field service based on notification and directly calling service order from the notification. And there is a material confirmation. Without confirmation, we have seen. Also, now the another scenario is we need to see the fields in-house repair. In-house repair is we will not have any direct service order created. We will have in between from notification to service order, a repair order will be created. Okay, so that's another process of second scenario is different entire business process. So, but the configuration and all we have completed. One is a service order, service notification. Your how the service order is getting created. So those are all we have seen. Repair process, we have a little more configurations. Okay, so what I will do, I'll create one service notification with S1. Okay, so this is my test in-house. What service sales order. So this is my component. Now I will go to the reference object. I will go to create a repair order. I'm taking the document type as RAS. Okay. And I'll put for one quantity. So this is a material which is coming for repair for a customer. So what is the service you want to do? We'll go here. PCREP will take the same service, huh? Repair. Yeah, PC service, I'm taking this material. Now, once you go and create this, R is not assigned, okay. Okay, the setup, we need to do it again. Basic functions, we are going to the basic functions, not basic, sales. sales order documents and sales header, sales area to document types. We'll take the same 1000 as in RS. Okay, so this I will copy and maintain it for RES. So now I will come here. RES, I'm just creating one order. RES. Customer is okay, 1000. I'll just save this one. I will not create any repair order. We'll see. So PC service now. /mm01 PC service. I use the same material. I will extend this to thousand plant and my sales area is 10. Okay, I'm extending this. So now I'll go to IW52. This material extended already. Now click on repair order. RES is my document. I have this material, one quantity. I'll put the service item. Okay. Customer, I'll take any of these materials. Yeah, so repair order will be created in the backend. So we have seen how the repair order configuration, right? The repair order will be configured based on the action box. Okay, so this action box is assigned at additional functions in the notification types. So this I'll show you again. So you go to the plant maintenance and service orders. So we have action box set up in the notifications. So notification content, notification content here. Additional functions. So for we are defining action box for under the additional functions. So we'll go to the business operations. For each and every notification, there will be action box. Not this. Okay, so what is your document type, S2 or S1? Take the notification. Here in the action notification, you go inside repair order. There will be a one function model assigned. This will create your repair sales order. So this setup we have seen. So now this also a repair order creation. Yeah, so now once the repair order is created, I'll go to IW52. We can see the repair order here. So last time Ravinder was asking if I have any process where I can see a repair order or any sales order. So normally when there are two options, one is here and one is here. This is for advanced shipment. If you want to create any consignment order from sales notification, you can see it here. Okay, so we'll see the repair order if it is created or not. Repair order is not created yet. repair order is not creating.
ప్లాంట్ మెయింటైన్ చేశారు కదా సార్?
కదా సర్వీస్ ఐటమ్ రాంగ్ తీసుకున్నాను, సర్వీస్ మెయింటెనెన్స్ MP11 సార్. Is set up clear? Okay. Okay, sir. I'll find out just on standard level. Then it's set up clear. Mostly then next week you ready just
for. Okay, sir.
I set up clear. Another level. Another kind of error. Okay. Yeah. This is we just completed the field service. We will start the in-house repair. I will make the system ready for in-house.
ఓకే సార్.
ఓకేనండి.
షూర్ షూర్. థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్. బాయ్.
థ్యాంక్ యూ సందేశ్.
థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్. బాయ్ బాయ్.